Thank you for subscribing to the channel. If you're not a subscriber, consider doing so. And don't forget to give the video a thumbs up.
And what that does, that makes it sit just a little bit better because you're going to be soldering eight of these or four of these to the side, and that makes them sit in there just a little bit better. And it makes them look a little bit better, even though we're going to cover it totally with Teflon tape. Now, when I get ready to saw it down, I put another little piece right on here, another little piece of PCB board, and then you just weight it down. Now, I've pre-tinned that, but I really shouldn't have gone and done that. I got ahead of myself just a little bit. But that's the way I'm doing it. Get a little bit less busy here, so you might be able to see a little bit better. But those two right there go, and you just lay that down and put that weight on it, and that'll hold everything in place. Nice and neat for you. And I'll go ahead and put that one in there, and we'll come back after I get everything totally soldered. Yeah, you see I moved it there just a little bit. So also what I did not say that I always do is go ahead and take a little Scotch-Brite or something and clean those PC boards up just a little bit before you start doing the soldering. Come back, make it just a little bit straighter. Then come back, stick that one. Get a good flow. And then I'll be back after I get all eight of them soldered on, four on each side, a total of eight. Okay, well, that's the first side of it that's soldered in. Again, you just have to kind of spread them out a little bit to make sure that everything fits okay. And now the next part is just putting them on the other side. And again, you do the same thing. Just make sure that they just leapfrog across those pads. Okay, so now you should have all eight resistors on the board. And you'll also want to make sure that it will slide up inside the tube at this time. Because it's going to have to fit there. So if you need to make any adjustments, now's the time to do that. And to make the adjustments, you just push them down. I mean, resistors can be broken, but they're not as fragile as one would think they might be. So you can just mash them down a little bit if you ever have to move them a little bit. But try to, when you're building, get as close as possible to the PC board as you possibly can. Now, I've cut a lot of the leads off of the resistors, and now you're going to need to take a lead because you've got to tie these two sides together on one end. And here's the way that I do that. I just take a little lead and then take some really sharp pliers, and what I do is make a little staple looking thing. I know you're not going to be able to see that, but you make it where it'll fit on that PC board there, just like that. And now what I'm going to do is just solder that little clip on both sides. Okay, you'll also want to make a little tab at the other end of it. So essentially what's happened, you've tied everything together with these two ends. So you came around and this loop connected that side, and that little loop that I made connected these two sides together. Now, before you go any farther, take your own meter and take a look at it. You're not going to be able to see it. I've got it off the side of the bench. Now, the next thing to do is, and again, make sure it fits everything you do from time to time. Just make sure it slides through there. Now what we've got to do is go ahead and get everything connected up. Now I'm going to go out to the shop. I'm going to go out because if you've seen some of my other videos, I've got a lathe. If you don't have a lathe, just go ahead and drill a hole in one of your caps, because we've got to do something with this RG174. Now I'm going to drill my hole. This RG174 is about an eighth of an inch. I'm going to drill my hole slightly bigger. Okay, I've got a couple of options. One option is that you can just, instead of drilling a hole in it, you can attach this type of BNC connector to it if you're going to use it the end of a coax. But sometimes I just like to hook it to the end of a radio, especially when I'm testing it. So what I'm going to do is just connect the BNC connector up to where I can go straight to the output of the radio that I'll be testing. So if you're using the B and C connector, I don't have one, but anyway, you would just attach it to one side, and then you'll have your ground running from the top end. You always want your ground running from the top end down through here, and your center part's going to be to this piece right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to solder some braided wire to this end down here. It's a little small braided wire. Remember, these are very low power, so this will be plenty of wire to carry that. So I'm going to go ahead and stick that on there right now. All right, so now that that's on there, now you just wrap it all up with Teflon tape because you don't want it to short out on the copper pipe that you have. Now leave that bottom open for the time being. And the reason you want this Teflon tape on it is, instead of black tape, even though this is low power, it does carry some heat. So you'll just want to make sure that you've got it wrapped up with this Teflon pipe tape, which you can buy at any hardware store, or Harbor Freight, or Walmart. Any Teflon tape's easy to find, as you know. I usually wrap it a couple of times, up and down. Just make sure I've got everything covered. So now I take this part, the center part of the coax, and go ahead and stick that right down there. And then you'll just bring this down, and I pretend that wire. So I'm just going to go ahead and fold it over with those pliers. And then I'll just solder those two wires together. Actually, since that's a little thin, I'm going to run that up and double that. Might as well. That is pretty thin wire. Make sure it carries that load.